Beautiful animation, catchy songs, and an incredible performance by Robin Williams have made Aladdin a beloved kids' movie since it hit theaters in 1992. But watching it as a grown-up can be a whole new world. Here are the wild things going on behind the fairy tale fun of Aladdin that you'll only notice as an adult. Disney's animated offerings have a long history of keeping their violence implied so that the kids don't notice. But not Aladdin. Not only is there a truly incredible amount of gruesome stuff happening right there on the screen, it's our hero who's responsible for most of it. While Aladdin is cheerfully singing One Jump Ahead, a song about how he has to steal to avoid starving to death on the streets, which is itself a little more grim than the average Disney fare, the chase through the bazaar has a level of carnage that most hard R movies would find hard to top. There's the poor guy who gets impaled on a bed of nails after he's squashed by a guard, a sword swallower who has the blade yanked out of his throat by Abu, and plenty of guards who plunge several stories into a wooden cart full of manure. That might not be fatal, but it's almost certainly unpleasant, and most likely results in plenty of disease. Considering all this happens in the first 10 minutes of the film, watching Aladdin as an adult makes you realize pretty quickly that this might not exactly be the children's movie it's advertised as. While we're on the subject of One Jump Ahead, it seems pretty weird that Agrabah's police force is willing to send dozens of armed men after one guy and one monkey for the crime of stealing a loaf of bread.
Thief! I'll have your hands for a trophy, street rat!
All this for a loaf of bread?
As a kid, this seems like a fun romp to start off the movie and establish Aladdin as a rogue with a heart of gold, but as an adult, this seems really suspicious. Don't they have better things to do? Like, for example, investigating the impending coup being plotted by Jafar? Or maybe they could devote some time to finding the missing princess after she sneaks out of the castle to mingle with the common people. She leaves when it's dark, and she's still gone at sunset the next day, but nobody ever goes to look for her. When she finally is found, it's just because Jafar has sent the guards out to find Aladdin. Get your priorities in order, guys, and stop leaving everything to the tiger. When you're a kid, Abu seems like a cute, lovable animal sidekick, but adults can pretty quickly come to realize that Abu is actually…
the worst!
Abu is the one who is reluctant to give his bread to starving children, even though they're cute as all heck. He's the one who steals a bunch of apples and jewels, even after Jasmine has already been held at sword point by a shopkeeper. He's the one who touches the treasure and triggers the lava that forces Aladdin to flee for his life in the Cave of Wonders. And then, on top of all that, he decides to cover Aladdin's eyes as they try to fly away. Any adult watching the movie can tell you that Abu is the worst animal sidekick in Aladdin, and this is a movie where a talking parrot is part of a conspiracy to commit regicide. Don't worry, we're not going to go deep into nitpicking the existence of the magic carpet. It's magic, it flies, and accepting that is just part of watching the movie, no matter how old you are. That said, while zipping through the clouds on a trip around the world is fun enough for the kids, adults who have a better understanding of the distances involved are going to have a lot of questions about how fast that thing can go. In A Whole New World, the magic carpet takes Aladdin and Jasmine all around the globe in a single night, but doesn't seem like it's going fast enough to even ruffle their hair. If we assume that Agrabah is somewhere in the Middle East, let's say around Baghdad, then a trip that goes to Giza for the Sphinx, Athens for the Parthenon, the Forbidden City in Beijing, and then back to the Middle East covers a little bit over 10,000 miles. Giving them the benefit of the doubt and assuming that the whole trip covers a single 8-hour night, we're talking about a throw rug that can hit speeds of 1,300 miles per hour, and that's if they didn't do anything but fly at full power the whole time. Since Jasmine's hand isn't vaporized when she dips it into the pond, the carpet was definitely going a little slower then, so its maximum speed is even higher. Forget about flying. The real magic here is that Aladdin and Jasmine arrive back home safe and sound without being turned to dust by the friction. Who knew the magic carpet was that powerful? Everyone can agree that it would definitely be a bad thing if Jafar took over Agrabah, right? From what we can see of his rule, in which he makes some unsavory advances toward Jasmine while the city becomes a fiery hellscape, it would be a bad time for everyone. The question we have as adults, however, is whether things are really that much better under the Sultan.
Now on, you're to discuss sentencing of prisoners with me before they are beheaded.
I assure you, Your Highness, it won't happen again.
Jasmine's dad definitely seems like a really nice person, and he's a surprisingly compelling character. But he's been under Jafar's thumb for so long that the bad guy is basically running the place already. The Sultan is indecisive, anxious, childlike, and fidgety, and it seems pretty unlikely that he'd be able to inspire confidence in his own people or negotiate with other rulers. Without someone like Jafar around to actually run things, even if he's running them evilly, those next few years before Jasmine takes the throne are going to be pretty rough. Check out one of our newest videos right here. Plus, even more Looper videos about your favorite stuff are coming soon. Subscribe to our YouTube channel and hit the bell so you don't miss a single one.